serious track competitors will benefit from installing an Evo 10 surge tank, as fuel starvation is a major issue seen by many Evo 10s that often participate in track racing. In this video, you're going to see how and where we suggest installing our MAPerformance Evo 10 surge tank kit, but the location is completely up to you. Let's get started. First, you're going to want to figure out where you're going to mount your surge tank, so you can begin laying out your new lines. We installed our tank in the rear fender well on the driver's side of our Evo 10, near the EVAP charcoal canister. Once you have the surge tank location sorted out, place the fittings on the tank. Don't tighten them down yet. This is a good way to make sure none of those threads are damaged during the install process. Head to the trunk and begin the wiring process. Using the supplied wiring harness and included wiring diagram, run the fused power wire to the positive battery terminal and solder to the relay's power wire. Run the relay ground wire to the negative terminal on the battery. We recommend attaching the relay to the battery hold down to keep it secure. Remember to shrink wrap and keep the wiring neat to prevent anything from coming loose and causing a short. Please note that we have an aftermarket big pump, so wiring here is a bit different than most applications. Stock pumps will not have an additional power wire leading from the pump. Now you should have a total of two wires heading down to the surge tank, power and ground. Next, we're going to take care of the fuel lines. We are going to be reusing the factory feed line for the return lines and running a new line for the feed. For starters, install one of the supplied 90-degree fittings on the supplied fuel line. Attach this fitting to the surge tank. Begin routing the new feed line under the car, keeping it away from all moving parts. Run it next to the factory lines and attach to the frame, using the supplied clips. Route the line up to the engine bay. Remove the stock feed line from the fuel rail and install on the fuel pressure regulator. With the supplied fitting, install the new feed line on the fuel rail. Install the push lock fitting on the stock fuel line and install on the hard line. Your engine bay should be done. Now it's time to move to the back of the car. Start by tightening your fuel feed fitting to the surge tank. Make sure it is tight to prevent leaks. Next, cut the hose off the new return line, the old feed hose, and install the push lock fitting on the line. Use the supplied hose to connect the return line to the surge tank. You'll want to make sure all the fittings are facing inboard on the surge tank, so they all align in the same direction. It will make hooking up all the hoses much easier. Next, head inside the car. Remove the fuel pump cover from underneath the seat. Remove the stock hoses from the pump nipples and replace with the supplied hoses and fittings. Run your new lines down to the Evo 10 surge tank and attach them using the supplied fittings. Before you finish up, verify that you're getting power to the surge tank when the key is turned on. Use this diagram to ensure everything is hooked up properly on the surge tank. If it all looks good, start the car. Check for leaks at every fitting and make sure nothing is touching hot exhaust parts or in reach of moving suspension parts. Lower the car and take it for a short drive. You shouldn't have any bogging or sloppy acceleration. If everything checks out, you're done installing your new Evo 10 surge tank. Keep an eye for fuel leaks in the future, but all should be good. Thanks for purchasing the MAPerformance Evo 10 surge tank. Feel free to contact us with any questions regarding this guide. Thanks for watching and keep an eye on our channel for more videos and on the MAPerformance.com/tech site for written installs like this.